Testing 1, 2. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome you again here today. On behalf of the National Museum of American Indians, we are celebrating our 25th anniversary today. How about a round of applause for NMAI? And today we have our members of the Comanche Nation, but I'm gonna visit with you just a little bit before we go into a program. Earlier I had a chance to say a prayer, and I'm gonna ask our singers here to get a memorial song ready. Preferably if you remember that Adobe Walls, because amongst our tribal traditions, we don't forget our ancestors. We have a term in our language. We say kewanai. That means we don't talk about a certain loved one. We think of all of them. We think of all of our loved ones who've gone on. This past year has been a tremendous impact upon our Comanche Nation. We've lost a lot of loved ones. In fact, today, laying a young tribal member to rest. And some of us wish that we could be home, but we have family there that will take care of things. But believe me, we're full of energy, we're full of talent, we're full of stories, we're full, replete with everything from art, history. You go up on the third floor and you will see the love that we have for our horses. And Beth, would you please stand? Beth is the one who's responsible for the beadwork up there on her horses. You go in the back there and you will see the face coverings, you see the harness and the beautiful beadwork that she has adorned her horse with. And you go on around and you will see a teepee. Morgan put up that teepee. This is Morgan Tosi. And he's gonna do a demonstration later on. But you go back there and you will see another horse with the beadwork that belongs to her late sister. We brought it anyway to make tribute to our loved ones. So today we've come to you, but I gotta tell you a story first before we go into our memorial song. There was this Indian boy, and by the way, in the cafeteria, they have a Comanche delicacy today, corn soup and fry bread. If you haven't eaten fry bread or corn soup, you're gonna have to ask for a bowl of corn soup. That's a Comanche delicacy. We asked NMAI to put it on the menu so you can see how we do things. And also, we've got what we call cowboy bread in there. Cowboy bread is made in a skillet really fast. So you get hungry, you go over there and munch out. There was this Indian boy went into the kitchen. His mother was making fry bread. So he sticks his hands in that flour and he puts it all over his face. Mama, look, I'm a white boy. Boy, she looked at him and she slapped him in the face real hard. Go show your daddy. So he goes into the living room. Dad was watching television. Hey, Daddy, look, I'm a white boy. Daddy took one look at him, and he, too, slapped him in the face real hard. Go show your grandma. Grandma was in the bedroom doing her beadwork, so sure enough, he walked in. Grandma, look, I'm a white boy. Grandma slapped him, too, real hard. Go see your mama. So he goes back into the kitchen and sees his mama, and she asked him, well, did you learn anything by that? He said, I sure did. He said, I've been a white boy for 5 minutes. And I already hate you Indians. Looky there, there goes Arlene. Arlene, this little girl right here, she's got a good mind of her own. She normally would dance by herself and enjoy it. But at this time, I think we're all warmed up. I think we're ready to go. Singers, I'm gonna call upon you for a memorial song. This is in remembrance of our ancestors. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise and remove your hats? Beautiful. You may be seated. Now, just to get our dancers warmed up and ready, we're going to call for one tribal song, intertribal song. This is a war dance song. It's a celebration of life for us as Indian people, as Comanche people. Not only is it unique to our traditions, but there's a lot of tribes in the Plains Indians, in the Plains, that have these songs that are really unique to our life. And so, singers, give us one song, let our dancers warm up, and then we'll go into exhibition. Stand by, Comanche John Keel. Dancers, you may be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to bring out our traditional dancer. His name is Comanche John Keel. Comanche John, come on into the arena. You know, 2 years ago, there was a movie. It was called The Lone Ranger. Lone Ranger and Tonto. Lone Ranger was a Texas Ranger. Tonto was Comanche. And in that movie, he had his face painted. And a lot of people throughout the United States didn't know the history of our Indian nations on how we have face paint. You look at Comanche John, would you imagine him on the field of battle? And he raises his arms and challenges you to a fight. Would you fight him, as scary as he looks? But you know what? It's individual. He paints his face his own style. Several years ago, we came up to New York and we danced at Pace University, National Museum of American Indian Collection in New York. And they did a book, and his picture was on the front cover of that book. He's very photogenic. travels all across America, been overseas. His style of dancing is unique. This is what we call him Comanche John Keel, because he represents our people of the past. Singers, one song. Applause for Comanche John Keel. All right, John, dance. Wee. Go. I just got a text. Target is having an additional 10%. Oh man. They got my number, you know. Boy. 1976, we came here to Washington, D.C., the Comanche Nation. We performed over here at the Folklife Festival, the Smithsonian Folklife Festival. We brought a dance that was ancient amongst our people. It's called the Tuhu Wii, the Black Knife Warrior. We mimicked the crow. You know, I mentioned earlier Lone Ranger, and people made fun of Johnny Depp, and he had a crow on his head, you know. There was a time when our Indian people were able to communicate with the birds, the animals. And today, we still have that means of communication. How many of you have a pet at home, a little dog or something? Yeah. You talk to that dog? Do you think that dog understands you? Well, sometimes those animals surprise you. They know shame. They know when they've done something wrong. But today, we're going to bring this dance and show it to you that we presented in 1976. It's called a Tuhu Wii. And you will hear this dancer, he'll go, caw, caw. We mimic the crow. But he's the point man. I mentioned to you dogs, he's a point man. He goes around the arena, and his job is to kill a dog if there's a dog that comes into the arena. And if you have a pet, you better hold on to it, because that's his job, the point man. We have no disturbances when our dancers come into this arena, because it's a powerful medicine to our people. He will go in the arena and look for the pets, and once he completes his arena, we're going to give him a song. And when we give him a song, he will dance, and you will hear him make that noise. God. Whenever you're ready, singers. This dance is signified by the black shawl that he wears around his waist. That means he will fight to the death. He's not afraid of death. Sometimes they call him Fukutsi. Fukutsi means that contrary. They want to die. That's why they give their life like that. Morgan Tosi is one of those individuals. He will fight to the death. He's looking for that dog. He has shot many dogs in the heart. This is how we go into battle. When we say we mock that crow, we take a couple hops, then we come back. And we take a couple hops, and then we'll come back. And there's a special time to strike your enemy. About a round of applause for Morgan Tosi. Morgan was with a Native American dance theater. He traveled all over the world performing. And he has an extensive background from the north to the south with regard to dancing customs and traditions. He's traveled up to Yugoslavia, to Russia, to Spain, to all those countries. And he said, we went to Switzerland, and they wouldn't let us dance because we were dressed in street clothes like me. He said, the people wouldn't let us dance because they said, you're not Red Indian. Overseas, they look at us as Red Indians. Well, they said, we showed them some pictures. This is how we look when we put on the Indian clothes. And they couldn't believe it. Okay, we'll let you dance. And the people went wild because they didn't realize that American Indians were still, they thought we walk around in the clothes like he's wearing. They thought we walk around in the buckskin dress and the cloth dress like these ladies are wearing. Morgan, that was good, very good. Since 1976, when we performed this dance, I was here I performed that dance. That was over 30 years ago, and I haven't aged a bit. I just can't dance anymore. Yesterday on Thanksgiving Day, we brought back another ancient tradition of our Comanche people. Aaron Navacoya, this young man, tomorrow he will be 13 years old. Come forward, Aaron. We have a tremendous amount of respect for the horse. His grandpa, the late Doc Tate Navacoya, and his grandpa, Wuji Watchetaker, George Wuji Watchetaker, they both had a vision of trying to bring this horsetail dance back into the Comanche culture. It was one of those ancient dances we used to dance back in the 1820s. But after the country was moving westward, after westward expansion, and they were moving tribes to the Trail of Tears and to our reservation, we didn't get to have the celebrations like this. Yesterday, we brought this horsetail dance back in memory of his grandpa, the late Doc Tate Navacoya. And this was a dance that we want our families and our traditions and our people back home to respect, because I mentioned upstairs on the third floor, you go up there and you see the fine work that Beth has done for the horses, the beaded face mask, the harnesses, and how everything. We really regard the horse really highly. Today you will see this dance by Aaron Navacoya that we brought back yesterday. And this is our time. Whenever you're ready, singers. Watch him kick, watch him kick. He's got a kick. What you got in your hand there, Aaron. This is a tribute to the horse. It's got a mane and a tail. We have done everything we can to bring it back with respect and integrity. Thank you. Once again, let's give Aaron Navacoya a round of applause. Yeah. He was wanting another one. He's not wanting another song. All right. Frank. Grandson? You see a father-son team. I tell you, this little guy is a showman. He's kenaura. He's not afraid. His daddy talks to him all the time. And his son, he says, son, you know, in this Indian world, in this Indian world, you have to represent who you are, but at the same time, you gotta make good grades in school. That's what we tell our children. And so today, he's gonna be himself. Monday, he's gotta go to school, learn. But these are what we call fancy dancers amongst our Comanche people. You see the eagle feather bustle that Frank has, that Daddy has. We regard the eagle high because it flies the closest to God. Yesterday, while we were here, I showed my granddaughter, brought her out in a cradle board. My daughter, my son. My granddaughter's name on the Oto side is Mungletwe Jimmy, which means eagle that flies high. And it made me feel good because you see that eagle feather that's on his back bustle and his tail bustle. We regard that eagle very highly because of that. It flies the closest to God. So now we're going to show you Fancy Dance. First song will be both of them together. Then I'm going to ask Daddy to step back, and we're going to let Corbin, little guy, give you an exhibition by himself. Can you do that, Corbin? Will you do that for everybody here? Okay, you're not afraid, are you? All right, here we go. Thank you, nephew. You've done good. And now, turn around the other way, Corbin. Look at all the people. They might want to take your picture. Move over there. Go into the light there, son. Go into the light, yeah. Right there on that circle in the middle. Here we go. Corbin Swift. Let's give him another. You want another song, ladies and gentlemen? I said, do you want another song? He said, ruffle. All right. Here we go. Sometimes when you see them move their head like that, that mimics the horse. Everything comes from the animals. You saw the crow dance earlier. Now you're gonna see our gourd dance. Marcus Tenneker, Valiente Herrera, and where's my grandson over here? Mojo. Come here, Mojo. Timam, manam soy. Mojo. Over here, Mojo. Over here. Look at this young man. See how he's dressed? He's dressed in his fine Indian clothes. This is his most valuable possession because he knows he's looking good. Does he need looking good? Yes, all right. And Marcus over here is on the north side. This is the rendition of today's modern times. When our young men come back from the service or they get a college education, an honor is bestowed upon them, like this red and blue blanket that he wears. This song we credit to the Kiowa people. Quanta Parker was very strong, our last Comanche chief with the Kiowa people. He has his own song. We have an organization called Little Ponies. You see Valiente O'Herrera over here. He was our head dancer this last Comanche fair in September. He's been overseas, an Army veteran, and he himself is proud and dignified to be able to present to you this dance. Boys, can you sing that Little Pony song? Or whatever you want. This is a man's dance. It's very dignified. A lot of times they dance in place. Several hundred years ago, we called it a shake dance, where men just dance really dignified. This is a starting song for a gourd dance ceremony. All right, boys. Yeah. applause. Good. All right, I got another message here. Boy. Oh, it says, this is from our IT PIO department. It's a mass text to our relatives back home. It says, go to www.comanchenation.com and click on live DC feed to watch all day events live. Three camera angles. Where you at? Oh, over there. You not telling me I'm live, are you? My gosh, our people at home. You know, ladies and gentlemen, you got to witness the men of our Comanche Nation. I want to start out with now our women of the Comanche Nation, beginning with our elder, Rita Barnhart. Rita, would you stand up into the arena? She's a very proud, dignified elder amongst our people. She's very knowledgeable about our culture. She's a language speaker. And she travels extensively throughout Indian country, giving talks on the dignity of our traditions. I want her to lead out a round dance for our with all of our ladies. This afternoon at 1 o'clock, when we have our powwow here, I'm gonna have her come up and sing the Lord's Prayer in Comanche. And these girls that wear banners, you see them, they are princesses. First of all, I want to introduce them before we go into that round dance. I want to acknowledge our Comanche Nation princess, Kelsey Cottinaw. Come into the arena, Kelsey. Yeah. Our Comanche Nation junior princess, Tristan Walkway. Let's give her a round of applause. Oh, I'm so proud of my granddaughters here. They are really good. Our Comanche Nation Indian Veterans Association princess, Shelby Mata. Yeah. Our Comanche Little Ponies princess, Turoi Pukuna princess, Katie Howell. Our Comanche Nation College princess, Melissa Collar Polway. Oh, man, I like that. I guess we're ready for a round dance. Rita, would you lead us out? Round dance song. Well, you know, I have to mention that Rita, she's a judge, a tribal judge, and she works in our child welfare department, and this is a lifelong position that she will hold. And anytime there's a separation of families, she works with them families so that they can have a reunification. And she tells them, Comanche families, you want to get your children, then you have to understand your traditions. So she puts that in their order, that they go to a powwow, they go to a social function, they go to Indian language class, and that's something that she requires. So I'm very proud of her for the job that she does. Round dance, boys. Join us out here, man. There you go. Not Numunu Wipa, Kim, no Karoetan. I call all of our Comanche women. Come on, women. Come on, ladies, time to dance. Gentlemen, isn't that a beautiful sight? Look at our women, how beautiful they are. How about a round of applause for our ladies? Oh, you're looking good. Now I'm gonna go and dance with our ladies over here. And I'm gonna ask those of you members of the audience, dancers, go get somebody to dance with you. Dancers, go get somebody to dance with you. We're gonna invite the audience. This will be our last dance before we close out for the afternoon. And I'm gonna dance over here by Rita. I'm gonna let her be Mrs. Chief today, since I'm the chief. But I'm gonna let her be the... There you go. Left, right, left, right. Visitors and friends, you may be seated. And dancers, you may take a break, 1 hour. You might get you something to eat, and we're going to come back at 1 o'clock.